Right, it's recording. Into balloon. Dig in the balloon, into the jar. Seal the bottom of the jar. Yeah, this gets a bit tricky.
What are you doing time here?
And you've suck the air in or out.
Out.
Pumping the air out. Empty balloon. Quick!
You have glasses.
No glasses. So we go for 20 feet. Yeah. At this stage, you're getting minimum return from it, so we let it out, watch the air go back. So there didn't seem to be anything at all in it. All of a sudden, it goes all the way back. While we're there, let's go one more.
Let's put this guy.
Same amount of calories, three times a eating. You can go about another 10 if you can.
Useless.
Is that about it?
Oh my god, no good.
Get my bags of this.
And we go one more. Actually, we got two more to go with this. This will be for one.
This is going to
expand, obviously.
Well, why is it expanding?
Because there's less pressure.
Well, what's inside there? Okay, yeah. So you got a little pocket of air inside there.
It's here. Who has a little bit?
What's that? That's great.
Keep going. Let's go with 20 quick ones.
That is pretty awesome.
Five more. See if it'll fill it. Although I don't really want it to fill it, but let's see. Actually, we hold it there because I don't want to go up the tube because I need the tube for one more thing. Okay, so all of this costs about, the idea in putting all of this stuff together is for other teachers. That thing costs about 20 euros. Can I have the yellow, the blue roll there, David, please? Blue roll, the fine paper. So the idea here is that any other teachers can come across this. I would like to order about 7 or 8 of these, so that rather than doing them as demonstrations, every teacher or every student can do each of those 3 little silly demonstrations. It's going to cost anything after the initial outlay. The site where you can get them is up on the website there. In America, actually, is where you get them, these things. Is my kettle boiled?
Yeah.
Excellent. Can I have the kettle over here, please? So, fairly cheap, and you can do an amount of different experiments with them. So this one here is boiled, so it's probably at maybe 70 or 80 degrees. In fact, there's one thing else I also want to do here, and that's slosh that around. Otherwise, you can do too much condensation. Yeah, let me find that. Find that here. That goes in there. And again, try to avoid the condensation. That goes there. And away you go again, boys. Watch that.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. This is it.
This is so useless.
Oh my god.
Pretty impressive?
Yeah.
Why is that happening?
There's less air pressure, so the molecules don't stick together as hard.
Very good. So you have less air pressure pressing down. So therefore the water molecules can jump into the atmosphere at a much lower pressure.
That's just because of the water heat up.
Does the water heat up?
Nope.
No.
So all you're doing is reducing the pressure that's on top of it. You have to let it out again. And we'll just repeat it one more time, just so you can see it again. And we'll put a bit more water into it.
Try enough. Try and heat up the thing.
Okay.
The inside thing.
That is. Let's put a little bit of water into it so that it's, we can see it's hot enough to touch.
A little bit of water.
Put your finger in. Hot enough to touch.
Yep.
We go again. I mean, cool enough to touch, I should say. Just let the camera see if you can.
Longer.
And away we go again. So water boiling at that stage is probably about 60 or 70 degrees. So if you're going up high in a mountain, particularly up the Andes or Everest or any place like that, the water will boil at 70 or 80 degrees. I don't know what temperature it boils. So yeah, you can't cook food. You take an awful lot longer to cook food up there than it would here. But you just can't get it hotter. Unless you use
a pressure cooker.
That's how you use a pressure cooker. Probably a water seal at the bottom. One more to go. This will take a little bit longer, but we'll try and we'll give it a go. Again, so this is a bell jar. You suck the air out of the bell jar and you get lots of different effects. What do we use the bell jar for mostly?
Sound.
Let's give this a go. Nothing more notorious to work, to get to work properly, than the bloody bell jar. We're going to do a miniature version of it here. This will make a buzzing sound, obviously, as soon as I complete the circuit, so bear in mind, it's going to be a bit annoying.
Sounds like a mosquito.
Oh, it's gone.
It's touching the air, so it's just going
to... Yeah, why did you tape to the outside?
Why am I which?
Why did you tape to the base?
If it's touching the outside, it's not going to work at all.
So the first problem with this, you want to show the sound is going down. The first problem is just by covering the bloody thing, the sound goes down. So that's not a fair test. Some sound is coming up the top, so we've got to cover it there. And it goes down even more. We haven't taken any air out of it yet, and already it's pretty quiet. To the extent, I'm not sure if the camera will pick it up, but it's only at this stage that you can now judge it.
Oh, whoa.